Allahu Ekber, Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber, Allahu Ekber. Eşhedü en la ilahe illallah. Eşhedü en la أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا على الصلاة Oh.
Yes, we have to pass this point.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى محمد وعلى آل محمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. هيا على السلام. أيها الصلاة. هيا على الفلاح. هيا على الفلاح.
لَعَلَى هُلُوكٍ عَظِيمٍ
I have created you with the best of character. Sallallahu ta'ala about Rasulullah sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem. Sallallahu ta'ala bi kitabın aziz ve alimu hamdallaha ma'al muttakin. And know that Allah is with those who keep their duty. The word muttaqin is usually translated as righteousness. Righteousness is knowing what is right and what is wrong and opting for the right and not doing that which is wrong. Today I would like to talk to you about adab. Adab, good behavior, good character, is certainly the most important thing for a Muslim to achieve. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, I am sent to perfect your character. And again in an hadith sharif he says, the one who does not wish for others that which he wishes for himself is not a true Muslim. We live in a country and in a world. Just few days ago, the rulers of this country, they showed not only disharmony and chaos, but hatred against each other. And it took them till the last second to try to save this country from economic disaster. 3 weeks ago, someone went and killed 20 babies, 5-6 years old. But it is not only in this country. In Pakistan, Taliban is killing young women who are trying to inoculate children against terrible diseases. In India, there are mass rapes which people are now realizing finally, which seems to be widespread. Who are these people? Precisely, these are the people who do not know right from the wrong and who do not opt for the right and go for the wrong. They are the fools, which last week I told you that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was running away from. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, the fool cannot repent for his sins. For the fool, before he repents for the wrong which he has done, is thus the worst sin. We live in a society not only in the West, but now it also spread to our countries to the East, because we like to copy the West, where there is no respect and obedience to the parents. There is no respect and obedience for the teachers. There is no respect and consideration for the older people. There is no respect for authority, for the government, or for the rulers. We live in a culture that everybody is for himself. Self-reliance, that I do not think of nobody except myself. I step on other people to reach to my goal. This is not Islam. You all know in your homes, when the father came, you stood up if you were sitting. You went and you kissed his hand. When he talked, you listened. The government is the father, the state. You obey and respect the government. You have a certain discipline. When an old people comes to your house, you treat him respectfully. You respect the rights of your neighbor. I remember in our home, when there would be a food cooked, the smell of which went outside of the house, my mother used to make a plate for the neighbor of that food which would smell. This is what Islam is. This is how I hope that we were brought up with. But are we that way now? We came to this country. Do we still respect our parents? Or, better, are our children respecting us? For the general idea here is the father or the mother is really an old generation, and anybody who is 30 is a fool. I know better. Are our children becoming like this? We, because we were brought up like that, we may go back, if we try, to the adab of Islam. But those, like our children, who are not, because of us, brought up with the adab of Islam, is not going to do it as easily as we can. For every ill is cured by the action of its opposite. Every sickness, every bad action, every sin, that is what repentance is. I repay for my sin doing good, which is its opposite. But listen carefully. If one is used to a certain way, It is very, very difficult, if possible at all, to go into its opposite. Because one does not know. One feels insecure of something which one has not experienced before. That is why, ibadallah, that if we wish to be truly Muslim, we have to think of each other, we have to wish for each other as we wish for ourselves. We have to consider others more than ourselves. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when Jibreel alayhi salam came and told me the rights of my neighbor, I thought that they would be sharing my inheritance. We belong to a very beautiful religion. Both our lives in this world and our lives in the hereafter for eternity depend on what we are doing in this world and in this life. When we see all these terrible things happening around, we have become so insensitive that we don't even recognize them, and we don't even react to them, and we don't even ask to ourselves, am I also like this? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, make your accounting before you have to make your accounting in the hereafter, where your hands, your eyes, your tongue, every part of you is going to be witnesses against you. We have to really be heedful, know what we are doing. We really have to study our religion. We really have to know how a Muslim is supposed to behave, how a Muslim is identified with his character. It is not by dressing like a Muslim, or by making your salat, or by fasting during the Ramadan, you will accomplish to be a true Muslim. All these are exercises to live and be like a Muslim. For if you make your namaz, if salat, and if the salat does not help you to not sin, you have not made your salat. It's not worth anything whatsoever. So all these are exercises to become a Muslim. A Muslim is a human being as Allah Ta'ala meant the human beings to be. Ya Rabbi, bless this Fakir and this Ikhwan and all of Ummat Muhammad with Adab Muhammad and Adab Quran and Kiran. Ya Rab, so that perchance that we will be somewhat worthy for the Shafa'at of Muhammadin. Ya Rab, as you have gathered us in this humble mosque on this blessed Friday, gather us on the Yawmiddin in the safe place under the Divine Ham and close to the one who you have sent as Shafi' al-Muzibin, Rahmatan lil Alameen, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rabbi, bless this Islam and all of Ummet Muhammed with the Shafa'at of Muhammedi. Ameen. Bi hürmeti Seyyidat Mürselin, Taha ve Yasin. Ya Rab, you have created us from a drop of dirty water and given us the form of shape of a human being. You have given us a mouth to speak. You have given us an eye to see. You have given us a mind to seek and find the truth. You have given us a heart to love. You have given us hands to give. Ya Rab, we look, but we do not see. We think, but we think of our waswasa, of our imagination. We see, but we do not take any lesson from what we see. We speak, but lies or noise. Those hands which you have given us to give, we use it to hit and to steal. You have given us this heart to love, but we use it for hatred. Ya Rab, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon all of Ummet Muhammad. Have mercy upon all of humankind. Ya Rab, in spite of what we are, you keep pouring your blessing upon us. Air to breathe and lungs to breathe it with. And food to eat and stomach to digest it with. Ya Rab, we cannot count so many gifts that you pour of us every second of our lives. But your greatest gift that you have given us Iman, you have given us Islam, you have given us Islam, you have given us your beloved as our guide, as our Prophet Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for all that, Ya Rab, we want more. We complain. We don't ever thank you. We thank others, but we fail to thank you. Ya Rab, teach us thankfulness. Ya Rab, teach us thankfulness. Ya Rab, teach us thankfulness and count us amongst your thankful servants. To test our faith in you, to test our obedience to you, to test our love for you, to test the strength of our Iman, sometimes never above our forbearance, you test us with a little pain, little sickness, little hunger, little problems, taking away from us things which we think are our own, but in reality they are yours. Ya Rab, although you say in Allah Sabirin, you will never, never find us with patience. Ya Rab, teach us patience. Teach us patience. Teach us patience. And count us amongst your patient servants. Ya Rabbi, you say, hold on to your religion and do not separate yourself from each other. You say that the Muslims are but one nation and one family, one brotherhood. Your beloved says, my ummah is like one single body. If the finger aches, the whole body aches. Ya Rab, we hate each other. We kill each other. Ya Rab, look at our brothers and sisters in Syria. 60,000 people killed by the hand of Muslim rulers. Ya Rab, have mercy upon us. Ya Wahid, Ya Ahad, have mercy upon us. Ya Wahid, Ya Ahad, create unity amongst Ummet Muhammad. Ya Wahid, Ya Ahad, create unity amongst Ummet Muhammad. Ya Wahid, Ya Ahad, create unity amongst Ummet Muhammad. And return us that strength of faith that beauty of faith, that wisdom of faith, which everybody feared, loved, and respected us, and we lost it all. Ya Rab, have mercy upon Ummat Muhammad, and create unity among Ummat Muhammad. Amin. Bi hürmeti Seyyidil Mürselin, Taha ve Yasin. Allahümme salli ala Seyyidina Muhammed, ve tarakab el asaran, ve kerer el cedidan, ve stekber el ferkedan, ve berik ve ruhahu ve ervahen, li beytihi min ettahiyyatü ve selam, فبارك وسلم عليه كثيرا 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 فصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى جميع الانبياء والمرسلين والاولياء والصالحين وعلى ملائكتك والمقربين وعلى اهل طاعتك اجمعين من اهل السماوات واهل الارض فرضوان الله تعالى على ال رسول الله واصحابه اجمعين امين بحرمه سيد المرسلين
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح أقامت الصلاة أقامت الصلاة